Greetings, knowledge seekers. Recently, our exploration of the baffling alien encounters in Peru took an even stranger turn. New reports have emerged from remote villages of disturbing attacks by otherworldly creatures referred to as face peelers. Indigenous people describe them as luminous humanoid beings descending from bright aerial craft to inflict grotesque injuries. Their victims are left with horrific skin burns as if their very flesh was peeled away by some mysterious force. Naturally, many dismiss these accounts as superstitious imaginings. But what if there is genuine evidence of the extraterrestrial behind it all? Join us as we examine these terrifying new cases through the lens of the ancient astronaut theory. Could these face peelers be connected to the imminent arrival of Nibiru or the alien imposters seen in Peru? Have these remote tribes truly come under siege by forces beyond our comprehension? The answers may be more profound than anyone dared imagine. Our story begins in the lush rainforests of Loreto, Peru, home to various indigenous peoples including the Icatu tribe. They have lived harmoniously for centuries, preserving their traditional culture.
True. We have video of the authorities showing up. We have video of the villagers running out into the jungle shooting at something, okay? But after the investigation, what they come out with is they say...
But since last month, an unprecedented wave of disturbing attacks has gripped communities with fear. Victims describe being struck by blinding lights from above before suffering painful skin lesions. Some have lost large areas of facial tissue, with flesh seemingly melted away by unknown means. Many are left disfigured and traumatized by the bizarre assaults. With no official explanation, panic and unrest is spreading rapidly. The earliest accounts trace back to mid-June in the village of Masizia. Three teenage boys were apparently targeted while fishing, struck by searing beams of light from a luminous craft hovering above. They suffered terrible burns, but thankfully survived the terrifying ordeal. Indigenous leader Jairo Retegui has worked tirelessly to document the incidents and protect his people. His interviews reveal consistent descriptions of the alien entities and their advanced aerial vehicles.
Que gobierna nuestro Loreto, más que todo de pronto la Fuerza Armada, la policía, porque nosotros no estamos seguros. Llamamos a Santa María y lo que falta es logística, nos dicen ahí. Pero ahí yo quisiera que las autoridades pongan la mano al pecho y nos vengan a ayudar a nosotros como comunidad nativa que somos de aquí del río Pintiaco, Alto Manay, la comunidad nativa de San Antonio, que somos los chiquitos. Y no va a permitir pues, que los chiquitos pierdan sus pobladores de esa forma con esos hombres endiablados, que no se puede nosotros estar tranquilos en nuestra casa con nuestra familia, como vivíamos antes, tranquilos, trabajando, buscando la comida para nuestra familia, y ahora no podemos salir, ya son 15 días en la casa y ya no tenemos qué comer, no tenemos cómo ir a buscar, porque de repente salimos a buscar por ahí, nos agarran esos hombres, nos matan y ya no aparecemos en nuestra casa. Señoras autoridades, quisiera que nos apoyen, que nos den la mano, que piensen por nosotros. Nosotros también somos humanos como ellos que están las autoridades tranquilos. Necesitamos ese apoyo, de verdad, ustedes, señores las autoridades.
Some have linked the mutilating light beams to experimental weapons or satellite energy weapons. But we must ask, what interest would shadowy authorities have in targeting remote indigenous tribes in this manner? The pattern screams extraterrestrial intervention, not government conspiracy. And the Nibiru connection gains credence when we examine the lore and legends of these same communities. Their ancestral stories reference divine teachers from the stars who long ago gave them profound knowledge. These beings were said to glow like the moon, an eerie precedent to today's terrifying encounters. Perhaps these newly arrived assailants are threatened by what the tribes have learned from past extraterrestrial contact. Their horrifying attacks may be an effort to destabilize communities ahead of Nibiru's imminent return. After all, indigenous cultures worldwide retain deep wisdom passed down from ancient alien visitors. The Ikita tribes are hardly the first to experience such disturbing extraterrestrial intrusions. In 1994, the aerial school incident rocked rural Zimbabwe when multiple children witnessed an alien craft land and humanoid beings emerge.
Can you just tell me very briefly, if we go along, just say what your name is and what you saw?
Nathaniel Coxall.
What did you see?
There was a ship landed on the ground.
Why do you say ship? Did it have a shape?
Yes.
Like what?
It had a round top and it was flat at the sides.
What was around the side?
Just a sort of like a platform coming down the
platform.
Side.
Did you see anything else?
Yes, we saw a black man running around.
A little man or what?
From where we looked, he was about this small, but we were quite way away. So it was about our size.
The beings telepathically conveyed ominous warnings of environmental destruction before departing in their ship.
The grass was burnt and all the living things had died there in that area.
Him and his parents and his brother and sister all believed me. And my mother just believed me, but my dad didn't believe anything I said. Anything.
And did you describe it to them? Exactly what happened?
Yeah, and I drew it on a paper and I said, Daddy, this is what it looked like. And then he saw it well and he said, Michael, I think you're telling the truth now. And then that's all he said of it, and that's all.
Who was scared? Not all of you, huh? Who was dreaming about it since then?
Yes.
In a bad way?
Bad way.
Yeah, in a bad way? No, let me tell me, you're first in a bad way. Why? You have nightmares about it?
Yes, I used to, but then after about a year, I stopped dreaming about it.
Mm-hmm.
I dreamt that the same one I saw without hair, he came into my bedroom and he took me from my bed.
Did you dream that?
Yes.
Yeah?
And then I just screamed. I woke up and screamed.
And what did your mom say?
Well, she just kept on saying it was a nightmare. She didn't really believe me.
I wasn't scared a bit.
No, not at all.
Nothing. It was all fun to me.
I heard this lady on TV. I think it was Jill Dark. And she said this lady got kidnapped and she had babies that were aliens.
And of course, Brazil's infamous Collars Island UFO attacks from 1977 come to mind. Over the course of several months, citizens were blasted by light beams fired from aerial vehicles. many victims developed strange skin lesions and burns similar to those seen in Peru today. Brazilian authorities could offer no explanation but dismissed it as mass hysteria. A distinct pattern emerges connecting these events to the modern accounts of face peelers. And they serve no logical agenda for any earthly organization or government. Some have suggested the collar's attacks were linked to animal mutilations that plagued the region. At this point, more questions than answers remain. But these indigenous victims and their painful struggles must not be ignored. Let us lend our voices to support and protect them while digging deeper for the truth. Working together, we can pierce the darkness with light and overcome these challenges.
Swing away.
The future, as always, remains unwritten. How we respond now shall define it for generations to come in this unfolding cosmic drama. Our watchful eyes are opened. Thank you for watching. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe.